Hey guys, here's a special record I just got in the mail. Kind of a grail for me. I've been looking for it for many years and just found a copy on eBay. Kind of affordable. This is a record that probably none of you have ever heard of and have no idea what I'm talking about. You can hear some of the racket in the background. This is another one of the records by a guy named Slim Gaillard. And he's kind of the court jester of the bebop era. Kind of a comedy novelty act. He was a multi-instrumentalist. He played guitar, piano, saxophone, vibes. Aren't that many people in the bebop era that were good enough to play with Dizzy Gillespie and Charlie Parker that could also be proficient on four instruments, plus sang and told jokes and goofed around and invented his own language. So this record is called Opera in Vout. Groove Juice Symphony, Slim and Bam Brown, also known as Tiny Brown. And this is recorded as part of Norman Granz's Jazz at the Phil or Philharmonic series. And I guess that would have been 1946, 47, something like that. This is actually a two-disc set. And oh, did I mention this is 78 RPM? This is a different record that's playing. I'm going to play the 78 in a minute, but you can get a feel for how crazy and sort of ridiculous and funny his music is. Let me turn that down a little bit. One reason I wanted this record, I mean, this is not necessarily his best record, but a two-disc set coming in nice packaging. Great cover art by an artist named David Stone Martin, DSM, signed as DSM here. He's actually one of the most famous illustrators of the bebop and early jazz era. He did something like 300 or 400 album covers, mostly for Verve. Let me show you some of those real quick. So this guy right here, he designed that, but this was a logo for the Clef record series that Norman Granz had before he had Verve. So these fine art drawings, can you see that? Maybe I need to zoom in. Zoom in a little bit. Pen and ink drawing, he actually used a quill pen for like fine control. A lot of stuff Charlie Parker in that era. There's another one. Charlie Parker, Swedish Schnapps. Again, the line drawing. And so this record that came out in 47 probably was re-released on vinyl later, 1955-ish maybe. Same artist, very similar cover, but a different cover. Same duo of bass and guitar, but much more fine, a lot more detail in there. Little detail work with cats and mice running all over the place. This is the CD re-release. The original LP release was a 10-inch. So all four of those sides were crammed onto one side of a 10-inch. So Slim Gaillard was this guy who just kind of got up and you know, joked around a lot. He made up a lot of really hilarious songs. Give you some of the song names on here. Meshuggah Mambo. Meshuggah is Yiddish for crazy. He had a lot of Jewish stuff in his songs. He had songs about bagels and chicken soup and matzo balls and weird stuff like that. Why don't I play you the actual 78 RPM record here? Turn off the CD. So, old 78 that's 70 years old. It's going to be kind of noisy, but, you know, sounds all right. Let's tilt the camera down so you believe me. There it is. Look how fast it's spinning.
We would like to play a very solid number. Very groovy. Title. The Groove Juice Special.
Groove Juice Special. Now you see the label? Don't drop these, they're super fragile. Thank you. So this says Disc on it. Why does it say Disc when there's two discs? It's actually the name of the company, Disc Recordings. And it also says Ash Recordings. So these were produced by a guy named Moses Ash. And this label that he created went bankrupt pretty soon after this record came out. And then he went on to create Folkways Records, which is much more famous. Folkways is all kinds of folk music, blues, and some jazz. And they have a huge catalog. What else can I tell you? Singing, playing the guitar. He did a lot of weird novelty stuff. He played the piano with his hands upside down, just as a joke. Really talented guy. He could play, improvise, you know, he could play bebop or any style of jazz and blues. He did some recordings with Charlie Parker and Dizzy Gillespie. And actually the only recording of Charlie Parker's voice on a music record is on a Slim Gaillard record. It's them goofing around. It's, you know, he's not singing. It's just, it's a lot of goofing around. Fun. I think he's a fun guy. Some of the songs are hilarious. But he created his own language. This whole thing about opera in Vout, Vouterini, and all these nonsense words. He actually, I think, created a whole dictionary of all these nonsense words that are kind of the titles of all of his songs. Just a fun-loving, creative, wacky guy. Slim Gaillard. And what else can I tell you guys? That's it. 78's over. It's only 3 minutes.